guys, I made the 500. Welcome. I'm just gonna quickly check on the laptop and then I'm with you. Right, so we're gonna quickly check the sound and then I'm going to play music on the laptop again. I do have to apologize. Apparently I am very, very soft when I stream like this, but it is because I'm further away from the phone. No, don't pause the thing. Turn off the sound. That's all we need. I'm sorry. Okay. So about 50 should be fine. We're gonna quickly play the music. And then we should be fine. Come on. Okay, that's probably a bit too loud. Okay. And we're good. We're good, we're good, we're good. All right. Again, welcome to the 500. And we're going to continue our spring painting today. The plan is we're just going to see how far we go until we lose daylight. And that's probably not going to last long. But yeah, welcome. I hope everybody is doing well. And thank you all for being here. I'm going to take my glasses off. Whee! Right, I'll try to see if anything pops up in chat there, but I'm going to read over there. Yeah, that's probably the best I can do, because I cannot see without my glasses. I am going to frown at you and see nothing. Right. So we're going to get our white. The plan is we're going to start with the sky and then I'm going to start with the tree. Not the grass yet, because I'm going to need the tree before I do the grass. Come on. We're gonna do the sky like we did the sky in the previous video by putting the paint on the canvas and then painting. I'm gonna try to be a bit quicker. I think if I can get this open. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. The only thing about acrylic painting, is it gets dry very quickly. So we do have to be very quick about it. I cannot remember what I used. Anything about my paint brushes, they get hard. Okay, we should be good now. And then I should probably get a dry brush as well. sort of blending. And yeah, then we'll just begin. So I talked to my friend Yolanda. Now she paints, she actually got the lessons for it, she got the classes for it, I didn't. So every time I paint, I go to her and be like, my friend, I need help. So she told me that the sky looks good and everything, but I need to not make a straight line with the grass and everything. It needs to not be that the straight line, because then it's not like that in the real world. So we're gonna try this. And now I'm gonna have to paint very quickly. Wish me luck. I'm gonna probably look crazy while I do this, but sure. I think I mastered the technique since last time. I'm not gonna worry about going over the grass too much. Yeah, I do get drunk like this. Now I'm just going to set my dry bar. Just a little bit of extra blending, not too much. And I do want to add extra white. And it's already starting to get dry. Oh my hat. See, that's the thing about acrylic, it's already starting to get dry. My friend likes oil paint. I'm starting to see the appeal. I'm starting to see why she actually likes it. Right, I'm gonna take just a block more. Okay. have to clean this brush in between. Because it's starting to get dry. But I think it's already improvement from the first time. That's good. That's all I actually wanted, is improvement. Alright, I'm gonna clean the brush. I don't have another one, do I? I only have a thinner brush, that's not gonna work. I'll leave you guys in a minute. I'm probably not going to get it any better than this right now. Okay. Next we have do the top. I can see that I will probably run out of white paint like this sooner than I want to. Really hoping that's not the case. But it is starting to get mess. Okay. Speed mode is really not working today. You soak. We're not going to blend too much because we do want it to not be too blended. Woo. I think if you can see from here, sorry. To the top, it is actually an improvement since the first time. What more could I want? I'm gonna take a sip of my drink and I'm gonna clean the brush and then we're gonna do the last part of that on the top. And then I'll start mixing for the tree. Oh yeah, the marsh.
I'm gonna probably regret painting tomorrow again. Oh my goodness, I was so stiff the last time. Everything was stiff, everything burned. But I like painting, so I'd rather pay the price of this, you know? Last part, and then we're done. Whee! Come on. Okay. I'm painting a lot over the side right now, but that's fine. I luckily want to do that, so it's fine. As long as it does not flop at the side, it's really good. Sorry, now I'm going quiet. Okay. Dry brush. I'm gonna give this a bit to dry. While it dries, I will start with the tree. My neck is getting stiff, but that's fine. I will survive. Right, gonna close this one. It's gonna probably take a minute to dry. I'm gonna clean the brush, start by mixing the colors for the tree, and then we should be good. I think this the image, my reference image to my friend Armando. So I'm gonna quickly go on the laptop, just check the reference image. I just want a blue, I mean a brown that will fit, you know, and then we should be good. By the way, ignore my butt. I will be with you guys in a minute. As soon as Telegram opens, Telegram is not opening. Start by cleaning this while I'm waiting there. hopefully when I turn around, Telegram will be open. Yes. I should probably put my glasses on. Okay. Telegram is open. Oh, come on. I'll be back. Oh, Armona actually sent me a message. Hi. Let me just text him back, I'm streaming. Hi, I'm streaming. Right now I just need to find the photo. It shouldn't be too far down. Sorry if this takes a minute. It can't be that far down. It definitely cannot be that far down. Come on, where is it? How can I not find it? There we go. Found it. Right, so the tree is actually pretty dark, but I don't think we want to make the tree that dark with our light blue background. You know? Wee! Actually, let me just see. It's a bit sticky, but it is dry. I just want to move it so that I can mix the colors here as well. Okay. So what do I want? So when it comes to brown, I have these. I'm not sure if you can see. I don't want to get too close, but this is like burnt. Oh, come on. This is a burnt sienna, and this is a burnt umber. So one is very dark and the other one is light. Probably gonna need some yellow as well. Now that I'm thinking about it. And then the white. And that should be every color we need for a tree. I believe. Yeah, I think so. Okay. So my plan is, we're gonna make the lighter brown color first for just the background of the tree, and then I'm gonna go over it, and from there we'll add shading and everything else as well. I'm going to turn this around as soon as I can pick it up. I don't want to smudge, but it is dry. It's just a bit sticky. Yeah, just sticky. But yeah, I think it's starting to look good. I really think we're starting to look good. What do? There is paint on my lip. This is normal. And now I'm blue. Okay. Great. And now we have a blue lip. Great. Okay. So the lighter brown, we're going to probably use this Sienna. I'm going to test it out now. Oh, come on. Open. It should be fine to use it just like that. Where is a paintbrush? What do I have here? A very dry brush. Just paint on the newspaper to just get an idea of the color. It's a very reddish brown. I think I can add probably a bit white. Or I can just use it just like this. I mean, it's just the background color, so I can go for just this. Now the tree is going to be on this side. It's going to go over the grass here, and that's why I want to do the tree first before I move on to the grass. So I think we're going to just paint this. This is going to be difficult. Now a tree does not need to be perfect. That's what I have heard. So. We're not going to worry if it's too light or anything now. This is just top coat. To determine what we want. And I just want to see, can you see? Yeah. That's fine. Alright, so this entire piece is going to be tree. So I'm just going to color this in. I should probably have taken a bigger brush. I'm gonna regret this now. this is the tree, and now I can stem out with the branches. I already need a bigger brush. I hate this one. This is not working. I don't know if this one's gonna be too deep. This would probably be better. Yeah, no, that's better. Because now I can branch out. And when you haven't painted in a while and your brushes are hard and a pain. Okay. Let's just continue branching here. And then we have one over here. The last one I'm gonna move this way. I'm not gonna have just three branches, just FYI. It's just for a quick line work. I think my little sister is home, so if things get a bit loud, I apologize. That should be fun. Okay, now I'm just color the entire thing. You know what? This is gonna be easier. This is gonna be quicker. And I am breaking the brush. My brushes are a bit old. I'm gonna ignore the stripes and everything right now because my brush is the cause of that. I'm gonna clean it and then I'm gonna try again. Same brush. Otherwise I get a different brush. If that's not work, we get a different brush. If this tree does not end up looking good, I have never painted a tree before. This is a learning process. I think it's looking good. Could use more paint. This brush keeps doing this. If it's just old, you know, because it keeps spiking like this, it's not working like I want it to. What else can I use? What we're going to use, this is what I get. This is going to take a lot of paint to put, apparently. It this brush is making it easier, smoother. I'm not going to worry too much about getting everything how I want this right now. Can you use a smaller brush? Maybe there's a softer, smaller brush. Yeah? I mean, if I had an issue with that brush, it's not going to work. This thing is loose. Why? But it should work. Even if it's loose. Sorry if I look quiet. The fact that this thing is loose, it's making it difficult to paint. Okay, I try to squeeze it in a bit. That should work, I hope. I think it's starting to look dead. It's actually starting to look like a tree. And not just this brown thing with pointing. Loose again. Oh my God. Do you know how difficult it is to paint with a brush that's wobbly? There's absolutely nothing I can do right now. Other than work with it as it is.
or brown.
Painting is not very smooth, it's probably my fault. So now it's difficult to paint. But yeah, it is my fault for it not being smooth with the dry brush earlier. But that's fine. Not that big of a deal. And it's gonna fall off now. Wow. We're brushless. I'm gonna paint like this now. Because what else can I do? Actually working. I mean, it shouldn't be working. This actually works better with it off. I really do have more control like this. Right. I'm gonna just go over certain parts so that it's not too lining. sure like it.
And there's a CG. I think it's starting to look good. I will lift it up as soon as I'm done with this. I do realize you can probably not see. Let me just move it. Is that better?
No.
Is that better?
Yeah, that's
better.
Sorry, I'm frowning at you now.
I wonder if our monitor says anything back to the hey, I'm streaming.
I do want to add a sun as well. Well, I just don't know how to. So I'm not gonna worry about that right now. I'm gonna do that in a different video because I think I'm just gonna search it up.
I don't want to add a sun and then make it look wrong. It's not what I want right now.
I think we're calling this Zenita 500 painting learning arc.
Paint learning arc? Yeah, that sounds good.
Because I have a lot to learn. Wait, wasn't the spring tree supposed to be on the other side?
No, I'm good. It's somewhere on that. Wait a minute.
As
fine, I give up.
The fact that I'm thinking about stuff like this after I painted the tree. Like, really? Really?
Our spring painting has just become the summer painting. I think I'm gonna make this summer painting then. It's the same colors, so the only difference is this one does not get flowers on it. I think that would probably work. So I can't say I'm continuing the spring painting anymore, can I? This is not easy to paint with that. I'm gonna take a sip of my drink, then I'm gonna see if I can fix this thing. And curiosity killed the cat. I wanna see if I'm on it as answered. No, he has not even read it yet. He has not read it yet. Okay. I want to fix this. Just because I'm having difficulty. I have to admit I have a lot more control. That's if I can fix it. Okay. Good. And it's back. I'm gonna press it very hard. face like that.
But I do doubt it. I really doubt it. So I'm going to turn it around
just for you to see so far. Right, so far I cannot see.
Hold on.
Okay. We have our tree so far. It's just one coat so far. There's gonna be shading, there's gonna be dark parts, there's gonna be lighter parts. It's gonna be my lips are because of that small part dead for a moment. I'm just gonna wait and relax a bit. My phone is still 72%, so that's good. And it's 2 o'clock currently, so we still have light. So hopefully I can do the shading and everything. If I do add a sun or something, it's gonna be here on this side. So the light part of the tree will be this side and the dark part of the tree will be that side. But we'll sort that all out in a bit. But I do think it's looking good.
Or at least I'm impressed. I don't know about you, but I'm impressed.
Okay. I'm gonna take my glasses back off. Whee! I'm gonna get a different brush just for mixing. I'm just gonna clean these as well while I'm at it.
Use that one for mixing. I'll bring another one in as well for mixing, but not this big one.
A brush wind rolling.
Okay. Got my mixing brushes. I should probably wash and soak these as well. And then we'll start mixing the darker brown and a lighter brown and then just a white. And the brown of yellow in. Yeah. That's what we're gonna do.
So I'm gonna open these. Now, I have to admit, I'm not currently focusing on if there's anybody extra coming in stream or not, because I'm here and I cannot really see. So if you're new on the Nita 500, welcome. This was supposed to be a spring painting, but I realized I done goofed and the painting is on the wrong side of the canvas. So it's summer now. On YouTube I will give a different name, but for this one it's still called apparently the spring painting. I'm not gonna change that now. There we go. Put the palette there, like that there. I think the dark brown, I'm gonna leave just like that. Just gonna move those and start mixing. I can probably add a bit of white. I want just white as well. I think this is good enough. I really think this is light enough. And again, I'm realizing you probably cannot see that. That's as far. Great. So I have a lighter brown here that I just mixed with yellow and white. And the burnt sienna. Then I have a dark brown, a light this brown, and the lighter brown, and then I just have plain white. So I'm gonna leave this brush here. I'm gonna clean these quickly and then you can see you. You know what? That's when I can soak. Hopefully it does not break off again. I'm saying hopefully, that's probably wishful thinking. Squeezing it for in case. Okay. I put it between my arms to just dry it a bit more,
because that's not drying it enough. This is the dark, dark brown. The dark brown is called burnt umber. And I have to say, it's a pretty nice, it's a decent nice dark brown. It's not too dark, it's not too light. I like it. For now, I'm just gonna paint the entire shadow. That's the wrong brown, that's the wrong brown. Okay. For now, we're just gonna be idiots. Used the wrong brown and I have to fix it again. Yay! That's good. Why do I keep pressing into that one? Again and again and again. I'm just gonna grab more and make it a longer streak or a bigger. I'm gonna have to stay around. Hopefully now I will not put it in the dark, in the light paint. Come on. So now we're gonna start by just putting a little shadow in. going quiet again.
It is easier to focus if I do not.
I think it's going good.
There's a minor piece in my
fine.
Need more dark. Yeah, I really like this music. It's very relaxing, it's really great for painting. And I got no copyright issues the previous time, so I'm using it again. But yeah, it's great painting music. It's relaxing. I don't know, there's nothing more relaxing than piano music. So when I search for music for my stream, or for my painting stream, I decided if I do find anything that's non-copyright, it has to be piano music. It has to be relaxing.
trying to actually lift it. I was worried. Apparently, I have nothing to worry about. For these, then I need to start putting the paint underneath the brush, underneath the stick, branch. I think I took too much. Never mind, I didn't. But this one on the top here. Where's the music? Give me 1 minute. I'm gonna check the music now. Give me a minute. I should probably put this down. Don't roll. Music, did you stop? Oh, that's the sound. No, wait. No. Hush. Those here. We're going back to the relaxing music. There we go. We're back. Alright, I saw a message. Mini Scribbler, hi! Welcome. I hope you enjoy it here. I am currently busy painting a spring painting, but I realized I put the tree on the wrong side and now it turned into a summer painting. So my plan is there's going to be 4 of these. So there's going to be summer tree, spring tree, autumn tree, and I'm going to read now, and winter tree. Thanks, I'm looking great so far. Thank you. So, it is a slow process for me, slow progress for me. But I'm very, very glad it's looking great so far. So I'm adding the dark shadows now, and then I'm going to be adding the light in the branches. And
probably gonna end as soon as I'm done with the tree, and I think I should end then because I'm gonna lose daylight, and I just don't want to lose daylight right now. I think we should be good with this for now.
I'm gonna read now. Is it acrylic or oil? It is acrylic paint, so it dries very, very quickly.
I am not much of a fan for oil painting, but it's only because it takes so long to dry. But I do want to try it out sometime.
Yeah, that's for sure.
It does! It really dries so quickly. I had so much difficulty with the sky, with the background, because it dries so quickly. So you have to paint so fast. Now I paint with my mouth, as you can see. So I'm gonna feel this tomorrow. I'm gonna be very stiff and in pain. I'm gonna need extra. We have a little bit of yellow in our burnt sienna now.
There's a medium called Lincoln that speaks of oil paint dry. That's interesting.
That's very, very interesting. I didn't know.
Yeah, so I do want to try oil painting. But yeah, I didn't know there was actually something, but still it's very slow compared to acrylic. Yeah, acrylic dries in a couple of minutes. I mean, I paint the background, cleaned my brushes, mixed my colors, and I was ready for a tree.
So yeah, acrylic is so quick. The thing of oil painting is, my friend paints with oil painting, because it takes so long to dry, you can only do so much and then you have to wait because the colors will blend and then it will smudge
and you don't want that. Have you been painting for long? Yeah, that's true. I've recently, it's a hobby for me. I've picked up painting as a hobby a couple of years ago. I don't paint a lot. My last painting was for my, what do you call it? The woman who gave me my prom dress. I decided to give her a painting in thanks for that. So that was my last painting, and that was about a year ago. I haven't had any classes for painting or anything.
Awesome.
Thank you. I haven't had any classes or anything for painting. So whatever I do, it's trial and error. I can just do and see if it works, and if it doesn't work, we try again. That's a nice thing.
thing about painting is you can just go over it again if it's dry, fix what you have messed up, and then you're good. Gonna read that now.
Yes, same for me. I started painting 18 months ago on self-taught, but I watched a lot of YouTube tutorials now.
Same. And I luckily have a friend, she's also disabled, that she paints as well. She actually got the classes. So every time I have questions or anything, I just call her. I'm like, dude, how do I do this? And she tells me in detail how to do it. That helps.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So it helps to actually know somebody that paints. But YouTube does help a lot as well. Especially my friend works at a school, so I cannot call her during the day. All I can do is wait for her to be done. Okay, now to add the lighter color and then white.
That's really helpful.
Yes. Yeah, it's really, really helpful knowing somebody that paints, and it's really helpful to just use the internet to your advantage, because there's so many painters out there and makes videos like this. So it's good to use them and learn from them. I feel one must always be open to learning something new. I'm currently not so certain about my light color or how I'm painting the light color. I guess it's gonna be trial and error. We're gonna see how it is, and then we'll go from there.
You're the first person I've seen painting on this, so you're amazing.
Thank you. So I was born with arthrogryposis. My ligaments are hardened, so I cannot walk or anything, can't use my hands. So I had to improvise for most of my life. And I've learned that I can draw and do anything with my mouth.
I did see one person painting by holding the brush with its foot though.
Yes, I can do that. But it's because I didn't have the movement in my legs to do that. So yeah, I learned to do everything with my mouth. The dark while I'm at it. Okay, sorry, just making sure there's no extra messages. I can't see there without my glasses. I can't see there, so I have to look at the laptop. I am streaming from my phone. Yeah, I usually do gameplay videos, but this is part of my niche. So yeah, I paint a lot as well. This is my new project, and I'm hoping it turns out well. And I think I just used it a little bit too much.
low, you don't have to check messages so often.
True.
True.
But I don't want them to, how can I say, stay there too long unchecked. So it's unfortunately part of being a streamer. I'm gonna take a sip of my drink quickly. And then I'll be back.
Do I stream often? Yes, currently.
I don't paint often on streams.
I live in South Africa. We have a lot of power outages. So I can only paint during the day if the power allows me to do it. So yeah, I usually do gameplay videos. My schedule is... Sorry, hold on.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. My schedule is, thank you very much, is on my Twitter, as my Twitter is in my bio. I'm sorry. My mother just came in to give me pineapple. And the cat came in as well, so she had to get rid of the cat quickly. So yeah, sorry. My Twitter is in my bio. I put my stream schedule up there. I put it on Twitch as well, but Twitch makes it look like I'm gonna stream painting forever. There is no just one day stream for Twitch. If you put on a schedule, it goes every day of the week. I mean, not a week, but every day you put it up for every week. Snacks! Yay! Yeah, yum. I got pineapple. I don't use Twitter, but I'm following your Instagram. Yes, you can follow my Instagram as well. And it's definitely there. I luckily put everything up on both of my Instagrams, my personal Instagram and my YouTube Instagram, or currently just my work Instagram. And I do so with my Facebook as well. And I've recently started uploading on Twitter. I don't use Twitter a lot. I just recently started using it because apparently that's where all of the people are. Oh my goodness, I'm getting hot. Pineapple! I'm so glad I learned how to multitask, because that does come in handy. Very good now. Yeah, a lot of people use Twitter. Yeah! I was shocked by the amount of people on Twitter. So I'm technically a VTuber, but because I stream from my phone, I can't use my model, unfortunately. I only have time for one social media, and Instagram is good for posting my art. It is. Instagram is really good for posting art, and I do prefer Instagram. Over everything else, I prefer Instagram. I do upload on everything else, but I keep better in touch on my Instagram.
Ah, goodness. But yeah, so I'm actually a VTuber or PNG tuber, but because I stream from my phone, my PC does not allow it currently, and I cannot stream my phone to my PC yet. So until I can figure out all of that, I am comfortable just being myself. Okay, yes. Like I said, I'm just comfortable being myself. The only thing is, because I stream from my phone, I cannot, when I play games and stuff, I cannot show my face while I do that. And it does bring it down for me a bit. I'm gonna read that now. I just wanna quickly finish this.
You're braver than me. I would be terrified to stream. What's the call of games to stream? I have stage fright. I don't know how I'm surviving this currently. I stream, well, any type of mobile games that I currently have. I play PUBG Mobile a lot. I absolutely love playing PUBG. I actually streamed that yesterday. Then for October month, I have this Halloween list that I want to try. So I have Bendy and the Ink Machine, and I have Goosebumps Watertown. That's not that scary. It's just the thought that counts when it comes to that game. And I used to have Minecraft on my phone, but because of Horror Month, I had to delete Minecraft. But I will soon be able to stream Minecraft again as well. A friend of mine and I, we started our own server. Sorry, let me read it. I'm playing Little Nightmares at the moment. Do you know that one? I actually don't. What is Little Nightmares? And is it free to get? Important thing for me currently is I'm not monetized or anything. So I need free things. But that sounds interesting. Come on. I think my brush is starting to get a bit dry. It's a scary one. No, it's not free. You don't do Steam then, I guess. I have Steam on my PC, but it is currently not possible to do a lot of things on my PC. It crashes a lot. So that's why I play things on my phone. And the other thing is, because of my disability, I am only capable of doing so much on the PC. So some games I cannot play.
I think I'm gonna mix more color, but I need to clean this brush. There. We need yellow, I'm gonna read that now. And we need some, come on, some white. And we're stuck. I should not have left it like that.
I see, yes, understandable.
Yeah. So, when I do find games that I'm capable of playing, I enjoy them a lot. And I will make videos on them. But it's sometimes very, very difficult to find a video that, or a game that I'm actually capable of playing.
Okay, time to clean the brush. Another thing that's difficult for me is getting games or finding ways to download games on my phone. I have a Huawei. And with Google Play services not being on the phone, I don't have a Google Play Store or anything, so I have to improvise. I have heaps of Steam games, but to be honest, I probably only play a few of them. I have a couple of games on my phone as well, and some of them I sometimes just ignore. I've played Heyday, and I'm very far in Heyday, and it's a fun game, it's a great game. I'm tired of it right now. So, I am ignoring it. Until I feel like playing again, and then I'll play again. But yeah, for now I'm ignoring it. Sorry if I go quiet. Need some of this. If I do need to move this thing, just tell me, I will move. What's the weather like there? At the moment I'm from Australia.
It's currently summer. It's very, very hot. I just wish it would rain because I want to go swimming. I'm gonna move it just a bit. I really want to go swimming. It is so, so hot. Now, I'm not
care to say that on stream. When I don't stream or don't show my face or anything, I just lay around here in my bra. Because it is unbearably hot. I am dying in this shirt right now. But yeah, for stream purposes, that's fair enough.
Yeah. For stream purposes, we can't do that. Not gonna be good. My reputation would be gone.
A pineapple. What else would be in a painting? I'm gonna go Google or YouTube how to do a sun in the painting. Just so it looks nice and there must be a light source. The plan is actually for just the tree and the grass and everything. There is actually going to be grass, not just this green patch. But I'm not planning for anything else other than that in the painting. Maybe a little bird or two, but that I will see or and decide when we get there. I don't want to end up putting in something and ruining anything. Nice. Yes. I think that's the biggest fear I have when it comes to painting, is accidentally doing something and regretting it. Like that's not something I want to do. I think I actually fixed this thing. I don't think you were here, but this entire paintbrush head came off. I would like to paint on canvas eventually, but at the moment I only paint resin models. I would like to do that actually. That sounds fun. Painting on canvas is fun, but it's also difficult, tiring, taxing. I am going to definitely regret this tomorrow. It is fun. It really sounds fun. Tomorrow I'm gonna be so, I think I need more. I'm gonna be so stiff. giving your neck a big workout today.
Yes.
The last time I painted, the next day, I could not move a lot. My shoulder blades were burning. Like, I love painting, I really love painting, but oh my goodness, it hurts when I do. And like, I do this to myself. How many people can say they willingly do this to themselves?
It's really starting to look good. Really, really good. I do want to add a little bit of white. In as well. It's worth it though, I imagine, when you see the finished product.
Yes, it is worth it. My previous painting, I was so happy. I like took a year or so to just paint it. But it's because I rest in between and
much white, but I can take away from it again. We seem to have lost sound. Oh, it's working again. Oh,
I am glad it's working again. You made me worry. I do have an issue with that. I think it's my earphones. Because I stream on my phone, I have to put the earphones in. I think it's my earphones.
So I do have sometimes an issue with that. I was like, oh no, not again. But yeah, I'm glad it's working again. I really think this brush is too dry now, because it's not doing what I want it to do.
I'm gonna wash it.
Here. Could be. I don't know anything about streaming.
Sometimes I feel like an idiot when it comes to streaming. I don't know much either. But yeah, it could be anything and I probably wouldn't know how to fix it. I'm gonna just clean this brush quickly. This should be better now, I hope. I'm gonna move the tree. And you guys can still see, yes. I think you can see more than previously. My hair, I really need to cut my hair. The most difficult part is mixing paint, getting the same color each time. You go quiet, let's eat that. If you did try oils, wouldn't it be a problem with getting paint in your mouth? They are toxic. Possibly. Now, I usually don't get a lot of paint inside my mouth, on my lips and everything. When I paint, yes, on my hands, as you can see, I am blue. But I don't have a lot of issues so far about getting paint inside of my mouth. Only when working with the tubes. So if that is the case, I would probably improvise beforehand. I think the nice thing about oils is it does not get dry so quickly. So I can have my mother help me prepare them beforehand. And afterwards, I should be fine and don't have to worry about getting them in my mouth? But I do think that's something that I'll probably do in the future. But for now, while I'm still learning how to paint, I think sticking to acrylic is the best.
I was more thinking of when you turn the painting, it would still be wet. Oh yes, that's an advantage.
That is true. That is very, very true. Now, what I've seen a lot of people do is they put tape on the side of the painting and then they just paint inside. I could do that whole white border thing and then it would be easier to pick up the painting. But I do see where you're coming from here. That would be an issue. I don't think I could even move the foam then.
That's an interesting thing to think about. Thank you for bringing that up.
I did not think about that.
Yes, that would work.
I think so too. I think that could probably be the best way of going about it.
This whole white line thing is a pain.
I could have left it like that without the white line, but the white for the wherever the sun comes from is important.
I'm sure I'll find a solution.
I think so too. Luckily I'm not gonna do it right now, so I can still take time and think about it, find a solution that works. And then when I do it, I'll be prepared.
It's difficult to decide where you want everything. Like, I had this picture in my head, but getting that onto the canvas is not as easy. Thank you.
I'll have to go soon. It's midnight here.
That's fine, no worries.
The VOD will be up here on my channel, and it will be on YouTube as well, if you want to check how it turned out. But it's fine, I appreciate you coming and sticking around. I really hope you enjoyed it here. I think the best thing about being a streamer is, hold on. Yep, I have followed your YouTube. Great. I am glad. Thank you for the subscribe. I appreciate it. I think that the best thing about streaming is the people you meet. I love meeting new people. But I don't get out of the house a lot to actually meet new people. So this is great. I have enjoyed it, and it's nice chatting to you. Yes, the social aspect is great. Thank you. And yeah, it is awesome being able to meet new people and to just chat with people. I think that's the most fun part of this, is I get to chat with random people. And even though I'm always very nervous, and I'm like very nervous, it's still fun. Like, I want to take a dry brush. Where is a dry brush? Do I have one? I do. It's broken. The plan of the dry brush is to just brush over the painting, but it needs to be actually dry. The paint as well and the brush needs to be semi-dry. I bet painting all that blue took a while. Actually, okay, I did 2 coats. It didn't. It was very quick. But it's because I speed painted. So what I did is I blocked the blue and the white onto the canvas. And then I just speed painted. And that's what I'm gonna regret tomorrow. Like, I'm not gonna regret anything else tomorrow but that. Yeah, I'm gonna regret it. Improvise when it comes to painting. Like, I know what I have to do, and then sometimes what I have to do is not something my body will allow. So I still do it But the next day it is, it's probably the worst.
Come on. Take a
almost thought I got paint on the floor. I would have been very mad at myself. The brush was dry. Unfaithful. I think the dry brush is coming in handy because it's giving the tree a bit of a darker shade. But at the same time it's not too dark. You have a lot of content on your YouTube.
Yes, I do. I started my YouTube about a year ago and then I stopped after 4 videos and I started uploading again this year.
So yeah, I do have a lot of stuff on my YouTube so far.
Now these days I put in,
I will give some of them a look tomorrow.
Yes, feel free.
I hope you enjoy them. Some of them are a bit long, but now with the streaming and everything, I don't edit anything.
So when I'm done here, I download it and I upload it just like this to YouTube. So it is, I change nothing. The whole thing is I don't want to change anything.
I don't mind longer videos.
I'm glad, because on Twitch I've seen people stream very long.
I have 2 screens, so I play a video on one screen while I play a game on the other. That's cool.
That's cool. That's like
with me and the streaming. I stream on my phone and I read chat on the laptop.
Sorry, there's a...
See, this...
Yeah, this is where you could, where you said not going to be able to do this on the oil. There's a mark on the painting and it can just come off.
Over there with the stoop.
It's not paint, it's just a mark. I'm getting very hot right now.
I can't even put a fan on
because it will just dry my painting too soon. I don't want that to happen. Put a little bit of light color in as well.
Fine way.
True, but you can remove moth easily with a clean brush when oil.
True.
True. With this it's already dry, so usually when I don't have something close by, I do actually have something close by. It's just like it.
But that's because I do everything with my mouth, so I'm used to something like this. And anybody else is pretty crazy.
During summer I use the acrylic paint really harder. It slows the drying down.
Oh, that's interesting. I did not know there's something like that either.
By how much does it slow the drying time? Did you count? I think the larger thing is making it look great, but not too dark.
A big fear in painting is making something look too dark. I'm gonna read that.
Well, it depends how much you mix in. It can slow it down a lot. I've had paints take like 10 minutes to dry, which is great for a wet blend.
Yes, that's great. I think I'm going to search for something like that.
When we get to the dirty paint shop again. Because I need extra white, so I do have to go shopping. Sometime. But I think that's something I can look into while I do that. issue with this is being able to clean my brush afterwards again. I'm gonna have a lot of difficulty. Like, it's great, it works well, but I'm gonna have a lot of difficulty cleaning my brush.
But yeah,
I think for, sorry, I'm not done yet. Nope. I think that's better now. I'm gonna get my glasses, and while I'm at it, take a sip of my drink. But I think for the drink, this is actually good. I don't think I need much else for a tree unless you have any suggestions. But I think this is good. Now, the grass, I'm gonna start by painting them upward. Looks wonderful, thank you! Now I can see. The grass I'm gonna paint upward, because I actually want it to look like... Nope, I think it's greater than this. Thank you! Now, the grass I'm gonna paint upwards because I want it to look like a grass blade. But I think I'm gonna have to call it here. It's already 3:30 the afternoon. The light is starting to fade. And I cannot paint when it's too dark. I don't know if you have the same issue, but I can only paint in daylight. I can't paint in my room's light. It makes the paint look different. I don't know why, it makes the paint look a different shade of what it actually is. So I can't mix properly or do anything. I paint on the artificial light. Okay, interesting. You need white light, really. Yes, that's the thing, you need white light. So that's why I paint in daylight, because it's white light. My room light is this yellowish color. So it does not work, it makes the paint look so different. But yeah, I'm done for now. So you think it looks good? I really think... I didn't thank you! I really think for somebody who has no idea of what I'm doing good. I'm done. I am tired. Right. I can't fit in. Thank you so much for being here. Mini Scribbler, thank you. I appreciate you being here and thanks for the stream. It was fun to watch. I am so happy you enjoyed it. Very nice to meet you. It's nice to meet you as well. Thank you so much for being here. I really, really appreciate it. Now, I am gonna call it here.
Thank you for being here and for subscribing, following and everything. I appreciate it. And for everybody else, thank you for being here as well. Okay, I'm off to sleep. I hope you sleep well. Sweet dreams. Take care and I hope you have a wonderful week. I will catch your next stream if I can. Of course, my next stream is tomorrow evening. Take care. You too. My next stream is tomorrow evening. I'm playing Goosebumps Horror Town. It's gonna be at 1500? Yes, 1500 UTC time zone. I hope to see you here, if you can. Thank you so much for everybody and for being here. I appreciate it, guys. If it's your evening, I might not see it. Then it's fine. Yeah, I think it's my evening, so yeah, no, then it's fine. Okay. No, it's fine. I hope you sleep well tonight and I hope you have an incredible week. I'm sorry that my streaming time is always so late, but it works the best for me. Thank you all so much. Now I'm just going to do a quick YouTube outro and then I'm going to end it. So if you all enjoyed this video, do consider giving it a like. And okay, bye bye bye! Thanks again for being here. Give it a like and if you want to see more of my content, do consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell to be notified when I upload my next video. And if you want to see me live here on Twitch, my Twitch link is in the description below. Do consider following me here. Thank you so much. I appreciate you all. Right, I'm just going to move to the canvas and then I'm going to end it. Right. Take care, guys. Sorry. Take care, guys. Love you all so much. Bye.